This week on Maker Update, Look Ma, No Jumpers, an ebook with no strings attached, the return of the keytar, and a pinball machine with no brain. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where every mistake is a lesson and trash is a treasure. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. I'm really excited about the show coming up for you, so I can't wait to get started. Let's check out the project of the week. If you've spent any time prototyping electronics, you know this tool pretty well, the solderless breadboard. These little things are pretty fantastic. They let you experiment with circuits easily and with very little commitment. If you make a wrong connection, you just pull the connecting wire out and plug it back in elsewhere. But if your circuit gets even a little bit complex, you're bound to be looking at something like this, which makes debugging your circuit a mess. Which is why Architeuthis Flux created Jumperless, a solderless breadboard that lets you prototype circuits without having to venture into the jumper jungle. Beneath the familiar but coolly jet black interface of the Jumperless breadboard is an array of 8x16 analog crosspoint switches. These are ICs that allow you to create and reroute electronic connections through them in real time. Put enough of them together and you can wire up an entire solderless breadboard with no jumper. Just plug in your components, route your connections in software, and experiment away. Just try not to let the blue smoke out. Jumperless also brings a few more tricks to the party. Above the breadboard, there's a header for an Arduino Nano or any other microcontroller that uses the same footprint. More importantly, just below every hole in the breadboard is an RGB LED, which programmatically changes color to let you know what's going on in your circuit in real time. There's even a switch to change the voltage of your power rails from 3.3 volts or 5 volts or even plus or 8 minus 8 volt analog. Jumperless might be overkill for your basic circuit prototyping needs, but maybe, just maybe, this is a glimpse into the future. It's not crazy to look at a solderless breadboard, as ubiquitous as it is now, and imagine someone originally asking, who needs this? And maybe the jumperless breadboard is the next evolutionary step. If you want to build your own, you can find all the files linked down in the description. And it's also worth mentioning that this is part of the 2023 Hackaday Prize. So if you think this is cool, maybe give it a boost. More projects. Also as part of the 2023 Hackaday Prize is the Open Book by Jose Castillo. It's an open source DIY e-reader that aims to make the process of reading an e-book almost as simple as a book made out of tree pulp. We've been following this project for a while, but this looks like it might be the final iteration. It all lives on a large PCB designed around fairly large components, so you don't need the steady hand of a nanosurgeon to assemble it. The instructions for assembly are even printed directly on the PCB. The purpose of OpenBook, other than the ability to read ebooks without DRM, is to demystify the concept of an e-reader. The enclosure is easy to print, the form factor is easy to carry, and it should be easy to modify to make it your own. There's even exposed JST I2C connectors to add additional peripherals for accessibility. This is a really cool project. Check it out. Over on YouTube, I discovered this project called the CinePi by Csaba, Nagy. Like the EOS M we talked about a few weeks ago, this is a DIY cinema camera. But this time, it's based around the Raspberry Pi computer and the Raspberry Pi high quality camera. This is a global shutter, 2K resolution camera capable of capturing cinema raw footage at a 12-bit color depth. Maybe that resolution won't blow anyone away, but the bottom-up nature of this camera just might. There's a screen on the back providing real-time feedback and a control interface. To learn more about this one, visit cinepi.io. And over on Adafruit, I found this project for building a synth guitar musical instrument by the Ruiz brothers. If you spent any time in the last decade playing Guitar Hero, you'll recognize this design immediately. But this one is all 3D printed. There's 8 mechanical key switches on the neck, a strum bar for playing notes, and it makes use of CircuitPython synth.io, which gives you the ability to shape individual note curves. You'll need a big printer to print out the body, but this looks like a fun one to put together. Time for some tips and tools from Precious Plastic. I found this video about how to harvest 3D printing waste to make this tabletop or other similar plastic forms. Precious Plastic is an organization that creates open source designs for creating recycled 3D printing filament. And in this video, they show you how to use shredded plastic and a heat press to create broad sheets ideal for construction. And the results are really striking. If you're looking for a way to create unique work surfaces, this looks like the way to go. From the YouTube channel Technology Connections, I found this delightful love letter to electromechanical pinball machines. If you open up a modern pinball machine, you'll find what's essentially a computer. But if you look at something a little older, you might find a machine that's literally a machine. All the circuits are analog, and a lot of it is actuated by solenoids and other electromagnets. If you want to see a deep dive of what kind of complexity can be achieved with basic electronics, this is a really satisfying video. And from Adafruit and Brent Rubell, we have a tutorial on how to use Adafruit.io. Adafruit.io is a mostly free backend for your DIY Internet of Things projects. If you need one device to collect some data that it will store over time, and another device that can read the aggregate of that data and react to it, this is the tool to use. There's a tier you can use for free, and you can get a lot out of it. And an affordable paid service if you need more. Check it out. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, Becky Stern has a special Halloween episode in her electronics prototyping series. You might think it's too late for your DIY Halloween costume, but this is a treatise on simple but show-stopping costumes made from simple materials and addressable LEDs that you could probably make in a dedicated weekend. Come for the cardboard crafting, but stick around for the hard lessons offered only by a proper road test. You'll learn about strain relief, keeping slack in your wiring, and some fantastic waterproofing tips. All right, and that is gonna do it for this week's show. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you had a great time. And if you did, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe with the bell to make sure you don't miss the next one. As always, great big thanks to DigiKey for making this whole show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.